been so many good matches.
It's been a good Valentine's Day,
you
know?
It really has. Like, if I could spend it with, like, one person, I'm pretty sure it would be you.
You know, I would probably spend it with my wife, but I'm here, so I'm going to spend it with you.
That's fine. I'll take it.
You know.
I like the day you walked in, I saw the shirt. I was like, oh, we're going to have great matches. It's going to be a great day. Some Rocket League that we didn't expect came through. And we were joking yesterday. We said, expect the unexpected. But at that point, is it really expected? That right now, it really has been. Because these rookie rosters have come through. But now it's about the veterans. You have Corrupted G. You have Jacob. Who's going to take that title as the man coming back from myth and creating their own storyline?
Oh, great drop down pass to Mekos. Love to see that right out of the gate. And Taroko keeping the pressure on. I know nerves are going to be a little bit of a factor right now for 72PC, but one thing I know, they have so many fans right now just screaming their head off for them, because this is a long-standing community, and just congratulations to them for finally making it in.
And if you're right now 72PC, do you work on getting Jacob settled into his role, or do you try to look to set him up for plays where he can start contributing and get that rust off?
I say work around Jacob. Whatever he wants to do, allow him to do it. He has just mechanical capabilities, that is for sure. So let him get comfortable and work around it.
Well, Lion Blaze is going to carry that one out. I feel like we haven't talked a lot about him, but he could be the crucial X factor. The third guy quietly in the shadows as an unsung hero, as he was able to carry towards mid, now into the corner of Chaos. As Mekos is going to boom that one towards mid. He's going to have a beautiful carry, but it is knocked away at the last moment. And Corrupted G sending it back. It is knocked away. Lion Blaze is there for the redirect, and he gets the poke out.
So far, back and forth action, but Chaos Esports and Corrupted G definitely have had the upper hand on offense, but minute of gameplay isn't a good, you know, way to judge an entire series, especially with the amount of nerves that you were talking about possible on 72PC. But here comes Taroko off the ceiling. Lion Blaze meets him in midair and sends it right back. Good demo coming out from demo. And Jacob puts that one into the blue half.
Taroko already has three shots on goal. None have fall just yet. But Lion Blaze is going to be under it as that ball booms into the corner. It's going to be Corrupted G who grabs it for now, but it's immediately met by two players of 72. Mekos now sending it back down long range. He's going to carry it from the ceiling, try to get the double tap. Whoa. In. Oh, just off the side of the bar. It's pushed away, and what could have been a great opportunity is now stifled for the moment.
Jacob does a little finger wag and says, no, 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 not on my watch. A great demo from Corrupted, but Lion Blaze gets in the way of Mekos, shakes things up, and no goal allowed for Chaos Esports, but they're not done with their offense, not just yet.
Taroko circling like a piranha right now as Corrupted knocks it forward. 72 falling back, trying to get a good hit forward. His demo is up for it. He sends it down. Corrupted is there. He knocks it back towards midfield. And now the transition will ensue. Corrupted now getting a good hit, but it's off the top of the bar. Mekos slowing it down as Corrupted is going to go for another center, and it looks like Taroko had a good chance, but it's just a little too high, and it gets sent away by Lion.
Again, very impressed with the play from Chaos right now. Tons of infield passes, tons of bumps and demos. This one going to go over to the right hash, and good catch here. Coming up field, Jacob gets the flick over one, but Taroko reads that well, puts it into his back corner.
This is truly the start we expected from both of these teams. It had to be back and forth. It had to be a bit of a stalemate. They're so talented together. This is probably one of the biggest powerhouses games of the day. The Lion Blaze wasn't able to follow up, and Taroko was there. He gets demoed on the spot. Goodbye, see you later. We'll see you in a couple minutes. Jacob now follows through. He gets sent behind. Lion Blaze redirects off the sidewall, and it hops down. And I believe Demo was able to hit it. He was. Mekos on defense, doing a good job of just pushing into the corner. Corrupted G moves in, tries to send it out, but Jacob is there. And now we go back to midfield.
So far, almost 4 minutes have been played. And just as I speak, the first shot from 72PC finds the back of the net.
Lion Blaze, the quiet man at number three, is able to sneak on in. He gets a beautiful timing on that bounce and sends it perfectly into the corner. No one was there to stop it from Chaos Esports, and they go down a goal with a minute 18. They're looking at a bit of a panic mode, even though it is game one. You want to set the pace and set the message early. Mekos now out of the play, and Jacob will be there in the back. Signature cowboy hat making its glorious return. Demo with a beautiful demo. And now falling back on transition, they do get a hit back into the corner of Chaos.
Good patience there from Demo. Didn't commit to that ball. He's able to get back on defense. He's going to hold that back line. You see him swoop in. Good clear. That was a great, smart play from a Rival Series veteran.
Mekto stops it from being anything other than a clear. Taroko now carrying, sent back to the corner by Jacob. Line was there. Demo now behind. Demo misses it back to midfield. It's immediately intercepted by, I believe, Lion. Corrupted carrying. He gets pushed out of position. Now another chance.
Oh, great
that
bump.
Ball is perfectly centered, but no one's there to follow up. Jacob gets bumped out of the way. Demo isn't there, and it's another booming clear what could be a goal.
It was good patience from 72PC. You can't send all three there, I understand, but it was wide open. Had this game been knotted up, that would have been the difference maker right there. But 72PC holding on, the ball going back to their zone. Demo up in the air. Jacob gets a touch into the corner. This one wraps around, and as soon as this hits the ground, it's ball game. Jacob gonna send it towards midfield, and there it is. 72PC take game number one.
While it was a close one, still not really sure where this series might be headed. I mean, I feel like we didn't get to see a lot of the cards on the table. 72 doing a very good job of playing defense on transition. They closed in some of those lanes we talked about on defense. They're able to get a goal through. On the other side, Chaos, they weren't really able to respond after that first goal, but they didn't make any huge mistakes. It was just a lucky bounce that fell in the way of 72, and we're looking at a series that still has a lot in store.
Yeah, and before we came on camera, I was scratching my head. I mean, 10 shots to 2.
Yeah.
And which team won? The one with 2 shots.
Yeah.
They just, 72PC just, all right, we're going to weather your storm. Okay, you're going to go for infield passes. Cool, we'll wait for the shot to come.
Yeah.
And the demos were even coming out from Chaos. So I love the resolve that we were seeing from 72PC. They were just able to hold on and just weather that storm and almost lull Chaos Esports to sleep. All right, they're not going to shoot the ball. They're not going to come into our half. And all of a sudden, boom. One shot, it's in the back of the net.
And sometimes the scoreline really does reflect what happened on the field. I mean, you get a couple lucky bounces, maybe the scoring starts breaking open, but there, like you said, 10-2. I mean, it was a one-goal game, and it was pretty even the entire way through. So we haven't really seen all the cards that these players have, and what's up their sleeve, we don't know, but I'm excited to find out, and I think the series really could go the distance.
No, I was loving how close this entire series was. I was loving what we were seeing from 72PC. I was loving the offense we were seeing from Chaos, but the defense just slipped up one time, and we were talking about it earlier today. That's all it takes in the Rival Series. You make one mistake, a team's going to punish you. And if you want to get to the RLCS, you have to play perfect Rocket League. You can make zero mistakes.
Yep. And maybe these are the players who are going to make those zero mistakes. 72, of course, takes game one. And it could have been a quick goal to start game two, but for now, still the momentum swing that this game could be. You need Chaos Esports to start finding success. Maybe it comes from the sideboard, maybe it comes from these aerials, a nice hit down, but it's not there. The shot just a little bit offside of the post. They're still looking for that opening break to get things going.
And still playing very dirty Rocket League. A bump on that back wall on Jacob. Got him off that ball. Good push from Mekdos, but Corrupted G's got an awkward angle on that ball. Has to retreat back to defense. He's just going to wrap this one around to his teammate. No, Jacob cuts that off. Good midfield D coming out from Jacob.
Jacob's been a bit quiet, so has Corrupted G. I mean, these are the two guys we talked about the entirety of the pregame, and they really haven't stepped up yet. It's not that they haven't been playing good, it's just we haven't seen much from them, and that's because the score was 1-0. But for now, Taroko coming off under his own goal, trying to get a redirect. He wasn't there, but it's okay, Mekdos is. Now back into Chaos territory. The ball going to get sent into the corner. It looks like it might be pushed up into traffic. It was. Corrupted G gets the last hit. He's going to push it out towards midfield and might be able to carry before Demo comes in and tries to steal it away.
And we just saw the first double commit coming out from 72PC. And Jacob came off the side of the goalpost to get that save. That's a very difficult one. This one going to be dangerous. Corrupted G actually hit Mekdos into that one. And again, tie ball game, getting closer and closer to halftime, and still no goals.
What we expected from a lot of these series today is exactly what we're getting in this one. A completely tie game most of the way through, a stalemate, if you will, as these teams are so evenly matched. They have so much to prove individually, if not a team collective. And for now, they're both living up to their names. It's just who's going to strike first. And sometimes that's all it takes. Demo on the side. He's going to carry the ball forward. Corrupted immediately stops him in traffic, regains possession. Mekdos will send that back into his own corner. And the only one there is Taroko. Let's see what they can do with it.
I think Makdos should have left that ball for Taroko. Didn't hurt them here. Good bump there, but no shot coming out. And there it is, right underneath the crossbar. Corrupted G with the first goal in Season 9.
That's what you needed to see from Chaos. You needed a quick score. You need to start seeing what they can do on offense. So much of Game 1 was them just pedaling back and trying to play to the strengths of 72. Now they finally break out. They got a good assist, a redirect, a hit, whatever you want to call it. It all works. And they take the first score of Game 2. Now Devo's going to fly forward. He's able to get a good hit off board. Does grab the boost. Jacob is there. Jacob looking for a cross pattern, but I believe that no one was really in the proximity.
Woo!
They were looking for, and that's a good hit. Taroko with a beautiful save and back into the corner. Okay.
Yeah, great play coming out from 72 PC, but better defense off that side wall to keep it out of the upper 90. Corrupted G can't quite get there. Looking for the dish, but just a little too slow to get in front of that ball.
Mekdos now hanging on the back wall as Lion comes through. And a beautiful demo. Demo intercepts him in midair, and that's going to be a shot down. That's going to be a second goal. Chaos Esports now tallying it up 2-0.
And when Corrupted G has such command like that, all three members have their eyes focused on him. No one's paying attention to Mekdos. He has a completely different angle on that ball. They're expecting that shot to go right. It ends up going hard and left. And there it is, second one for Chaos Esports.
We were waiting for one team to just take advantage where they needed to, and finally, Chaos does it. It beautifully hit off the top wall. It could be a number three, but Jacob was trying to make it a 2-1 game. It just isn't able to follow through, and the defense stacked inside the box for Chaos is a little too strong for now.
Ooh, off the ceiling. This is going to be dangerous. Got the reset, and that one going away, but Taroko keeping pressure. Jacob, so solid on that back wall.
We're up to G looking for a nice hit. No one was there. Mekdos now following in pursuit. He does get a bounce off the ball. It's going to be sent back to midfield. Corrupted G now flying to meet it. Immediately sent away. Jacob came over the top. You can see him flying past. As Mekdos now hovering, staying alive with that ball, trying to control the pace. But Lion Blaze gets a good hit. Jacob now with the carry. It's sent into the corner. No one to follow through. Demo was looking for at least a center. No one was there. And a beautiful stop for Mekdos. And they just hold that defensive pressure now. 72 looking for a quick score.
And they're getting their looks this game. They've had plenty of opportunities. 5 shots so far in this matchup, but the defense has just been stellar from Chaos Esports.
And this series really might go the distance if these games continue to play out the way we expected. Chaos finally breaking the seal open. The hardest points to get are always the first. They do it. They get the insurance policy with it. You can chalk that one up to good plays all around. Lion Blaze trying to make some magic happen. This might be a decent opportunity before it gets knocked away. Mekdos is there. He sends it back into the orange side. And this could be all Shiroh in the next 20 or so seconds. They can't get a hit down. 72 trying their best, but it's immediately knocked away.
7 saves for Chaos Esports, 8 shots for 72 PC. Every single time they've tried to look at the net, Chaos has shut the blinds.
Well, you got 8 seconds. Can you get 2 goals? Odds are probably not. There's a good opportunity. 5 seconds, but Jacob is able to at least bring this game back to 1. And now you're looking at a situation where it would take a miracle to steal this game. And if they do, I mean, just imagine if they do.
I mean,
how much momentum would be taken?
Oh, a ton. But I think that's the first goal Jacob's had in over a year in the Rocket League esports ecosystem. I mean, good to see his name back up there.
That's absolutely. That's the one good takeaway if you're 72. Oh, looks like it might have been a 3-1 win, but for now, game is over. Game is dusted. And Jacob gets some of that rust off, finally gets his first goal in a couple of Earth revolutions, but, well, sometimes it's a little too far out of reach. And I think that's really where Chaos showed up. Again, these guys have been here before. They were in Rivals last time. We've seen what they can do. They placed 4th last year, but right now they are showing Jacob that 2 years is a bit of time, but you still have to keep up with the meta. And as of right now, I mean, he's just not.
Yeah, and both RLCS vets getting their goals here in the second matchup. But I think the difference maker in Game 2 compared to Game 1 was the double commits that we saw from 72 PC. They were rare. Didn't happen all match, but there were two that stand out in my mind in particular, yep. And they happened in the offensive half. You can't be having that because it's going to turn into transition offense for your opponents, and you're forcing your last man back in possibly a 2v1 or 3v1 scenario. Not good in terms of Rocket League.
Yeah, and this comes back to just the whole defensive problems that they've had from weeks prior. We've talked about their double commits on defense and the fact that good defense leads to great offense. The problem is that they get caught napping a couple of times. They had a couple of unlucky hits, sure, but at the end of the day, you have to be able to respond. They weren't able to do it. That's two unanswered goals. Now moving into game three, this is really where the series will break open. I have a strong feeling whoever takes, obviously, game three, I think they're going to swing this series wide open. They're going to be able to seal in game four. We could be looking at a 3-1 win for either side.
No, definitely a huge momentum match here, and I think both teams realize that going into this one, so very important. But I'm curious, is it going to start off slow like games one and two, or are we going to see a quick goal in the first minute?
Well, Taroko wants to get that demo out of the way, and he might be able to do it all. This could be a perfect opportunity. No, the shot's blocked. Taroko was back. He was waiting. And off the start of game three, he is the man you want to look for with a nice hit out of his base. The Lion Blaze is there to meet up, and they're going to try to get a quick goal here.
That was a great pass from Jacob. I love the bait to get defenders away, but the shot just went right down the gut, and the defender was sitting right there. Easy save, but Lion Blaze won't be his last opportunity. He's coming off the ceiling, has his flip, gets it over one towards the net, and Corrupted G there for the last second save.
Corrupted G just saved what was potentially one of the best goals we've seen today at the start of the series and the start of the season itself. Corrupted G coming big, and that's what you need from him, but there's another booming clear. Mekdos meets it at midfield before it's knocked away by Lion. Sent up for demo, he gets a good hit. Right over the side of Taroko, it's pushed into the corner of Chaos. And finally, they have some control for 72. But just as I say that, flying back on D, it's Corrupted. He gets a big demo. And now Jacob has to basically take on three guys at once.
That's a dangerous clear there from Mekdos, putting it right towards center field for 72 PC. And the rotation's great right now, but that one gets away from Lion Blaze. Taroko makes him pay, puts it right in the orange half. And Jacob there gets that one dunked, and Mekdos puts it back into the zone. Great pressure from Chaos Esports.
These intercepts by Chaos are what's really standing apart. When you look at 72, they just haven't had the same success on defense, but for now, they might have had a quick goal there if it wasn't for Corrupted and Taroko. As Demo pushes it under, but he's just not able to get a good read on, and now Jacob has to fall back with no boost to work with. Finally, does get the side. He can start to juggle this one forward. Is anyone there to meet him? They are. And now it's pushed back into the corner of Chaos.
I'm loving the gameplay we're seeing right now. Some people think, 0-0, it's not fun, but this is like a chess match right now. It's just pieces moving and pawns being discarded and knights, whatever L moves they make, I don't know, Achieves would be able to make those references.
3-2 move, of course.
But man, it's so fun watching the dynamic between both teams shift as the clock ticks down.
We've seen a lot of checkers today. This is a complete chess match. The score doesn't necessarily reflect it, but I'm telling you, from just the looks of everything on field, these teams could not be more evenly matched if they tried. And their stories are so similar. Corrupted G now waiting patiently for a fall down as he's going to knock it forward. Taroko's falling behind. Corrupted G going to go ahead and go after it. He gets some boost. Taroko's able to knock it away just before it looked like it might have an opportunity to fall in. And still playing great defense is Chaos. Here's another hit out. And that's just good spatial awareness from Chaos.
Taroko coming out of nowhere, out of the sky to get that save. Seemed like he went off the ceiling there because he held onto his flip for a long time. Love to take another look at that one, but here comes Lion Blaze. Misplays that ball, doesn't get the flick and a turnover at midfield.
Lion Blaze was trying to lead Demo into the goal. Unfortunately, he didn't get the pass through. That's a dangerous hit, but it's not a dangerous save. It's an easy one for Corrupted. Jacob now sends it back. He's waiting for someone to hit it. Demo was there. He sends it back to Jacob. Now back towards the blue side. Mekdos goes up for it. Here comes Demo staring at the ground. And here comes another shot down. It doesn't connect. Jacob with a slight tap, but it isn't enough to redirect. Corrupted now with a shot. It's immediately pushed away from Demo. There's another Demo for you as Corrupted gets boost back. And now back on transition is Chaos.
Great dunk from Jacob there. Keeps that ball in the blue zone. Nearing the final minute of gameplay, Lion Blaze just pokes that one up, but it's right to Corrupted G. Mekdos off that back wall. These teams continue to go back and forth, neither one willing to budge. But eventually, someone's going to find a chink in the armor, and that's all it's going to take.
If only Jacob had some boost to work with. He was sitting at an empty tank. And that's the biggest problem when going for a double touch. Sometimes you just don't have the resources. Well, he gets a hit into the corner off the side wall. Jacob's still controlling that side of the pitch. And it's now up for grabs. It's still in traffic. Lion Blaze flying back for some boost. Taroko hovering, waiting, trying to redirect if he can.
Here
comes
we go.
Lion Blaze. This could be an opportunity, but it's Taroko, of course. The man's there with only 30 seconds. Someone's trying to find a hole. This could be it. Oh, no, it's knocked away. I believe Mektos was the one who touched it.
Oh, Lion Blaze. He is getting warmed up and just gets turned away on that shot. Taroko looking for the turnaround offense, but pass forward to Jacob. Final 10 seconds. This ball's in the air. Corrupted G's alone back on defense. Has to stretch. Gets the save. And one last try for 72PC. This ball goes down and into overtime we go.
I thought Jacob might have had an opportunity, but three players from Chaos were waiting. No chance there. And into overtime, Jacob trying to be a hero. Corrupted G trying to rewrite history. And steal this game. Go up 2-1 in the series. Still tight, 0-0. Lion Blaze now, full boost. Jacob following suit. He does get a bump. Oh, this might be an opportunity. It's immediately knocked away as soon as I say that. The defense from Chaos, too strong.
Oh, Demo coming off the ceiling. Good read there. Corrupted G gets demoed off the field. Mektos all alone in the backfield. Corrupted G spawns on the perfect side to help his team out. Gets a touch on that ball. Sends it towards midfield, and it's Chaos's turn. That offense, and as soon as I say that, the rookie steps up and ends overtime.
He was the third man, the unsung hero, whatever you want to call him. He shows up big. One goal when it mattered, no assists, you didn't need him. Lion Blaze helping 72PC steal, secure game three. This is the momentum swing we talked about. Could we be looking at a 3-1 win for 72, or are we going the distance? Tsubi, I really do not know. I mean, these games have been so close. Even 2-0 was close. I mean, who knows what's going to happen?
I don't know. It's just one team shoots 10 shots one game, and then next game they get limited to 4. And they're just going back and forth. The first game, 72PC had 2. This game they had 13 or something. Math.
Something,
yeah, 13.
Something like
Ooh,
that.
That's quick math. I am doing well. But, I mean, they limit Chaos to just 4 shots.
Yeah.
So these teams are just back and forth, and Chaos, I really think they need to look out for Lion Blaze. He is starting to warm up, and I saw a few times where he's going for that flip reset, and he's just inches away from burying it under the net. They have to respect him when he goes up in the air, or they are going to get punished.
And as he's getting warmed up, that gives more time for Jacob and Demo to do their thing. So you worried about rust for Jacob, you don't got to worry about it anymore. Of course, he gets a goal in game two, but still, you have to look at the fact that, or game three, I should say, but you have to look at the fact that even now, Jacob doesn't have that much pressure on him. I mean, he's got one goal already, so the rust is gone. But you have teammates stepping up. You have Lion Blaze, who we didn't give a lot of shout-outs to on the desk, but we still said this team has the ability to, you know, make a good run through the season. Jacob now has a couple of opportunities to get the rust off, start working through his teammates. They can start following him. I asked you, I said, what do they need to do to get Jacob comfortable? You said just play through his lead. Right now, it's the complete opposite. They're playing their own lead, and Jacob can just follow behind.
Well, I mean, hey, you got to do whatever he's comfortable with. And right now, if he's comfortable just being the third man in rotation, which he's not, but whatever he's comfortable with, stick with it because it's working. And a great pass from Jacob down to Lion Blaze. Good cutoff from Corrupted G. But another big difference in game number three was the demos coming out from 72PC, really shaking up Chaos. And look
oh,
at the
that
back
beautiful
door
bump.
Pass.
Demo, beautiful bump, and Lion Blaze punches it home. Oh, you can see that from a mile away. Demo gets the bump. He immediately backs on up. And those taillights look so pretty in the rearview mirror. Lion Blaze comes in and cleans it up. And that's a quick goal. 72PC come out and they strike hot, looking to close this series.
That's like a little Allen Iverson behind the back pass
oh,
from him.
So
just made the defender look silly.
And like we talk about a chess match, sometimes checkers is also a preferable game type. So you have to make it work. You have to make it work where you can. Jacob now, Lion Blaze following behind. Here comes an opportunity. Mektos hits it up. Who's going to be there? Demo is there. He immediately stops that aggressive push. He's going to have to grab some boost while he's at it. Lionblaze sends it out on the same page. Doesn't have to work with. Oh, it splits the defenders. You can't let that happen. Taroko's saying, I'll take one of my own.
Just sneaks it in, and who goes low? Taroko goes low under two. Two defenders pre-jumping. Good heads-up play from the veteran.
72 goes low, we'll also go low, and it all works out in the end. Now a tie game. What more could you want for a decisive game four? Plenty of time, I mean, all the time in the world to work with, and this could be one for the storybooks as we wait to see the winner of this match. Could be 72 with a 3-1 win in the series, or we could go to game five. What looked like a decent hit now as Jacob now has to play back and try to hit this for a center. Is pushed away. Chaos doing a great job on defense with a great offensive push in the last go-around. Still ball up for Contest, who's in the corner. Here comes Corrupted G with a flyover. It's now centered up. Can anyone get a double touch? No. Mektos kind of sitting quietly on the side. I believe he was waiting for the bad bounce to come through, but he might have had an opportunity to go for the hit, but for now, nothing.
And somehow, 72PC weathered that storm and did so well, all with over 50 boosted left in their tank. Even when Chaos was going for boost steals, they got the left corner, the left mid, and still, 72PC didn't worry.
We're up to G waiting for that hit. Oh, they might have an opportunity, but it's a demo in the air. That creates a distraction for no follow-up. Lionblaze comes out of goal. He starts to carry it forward. Jacob is over top. The assist working well, but no one is following up. That's another bump. Mektos with a hit. Lionblaze with a clear and a save to his name. Corrupted G now just misses another touch, but still, back and forth we go. Who's gonna strike first? It's still too close to call. And that's a push out to the corner. He grabs the boost on his way down. Lionblaze now falling back. Jacob's gonna be there for the hit. Could Jacob have an opportunity to just really seal this game away? Who's gonna create the tiebreaker? Demo trying to do it. It's up for Mektos. He gets a nice hit to the ceiling. Jacob playing off the web. He falls down. Corrupted G following suit. Demo now hits it off the sidewall. Corrupted going for it. Lionblaze flying over. He gets it out. And back into the corner of 72. As they look to play some defense. Splits a couple of defenders. And here comes a shot. And there it goes, Mektos.
Makes the defenders look silly. You see one on the left, one on the right, but the pass from Taroko, so crucial to get it into the box. Nothing could be done, and Chaos come up early.
Couple of holes on those defensive commits, some of those defensive pushes, and that's why Chaos have taken the lead here. Still plenty of time. I mean, there's so much that could happen, but for right now, Chaos feeling good, looking for an insurance goal. Taroko making that happen. Now a 3-1. Two goals in a matter of about 10, 15 seconds.
And Taroko quiet the entire series, gets that goal with the help of the distraction from Corrupted G. Nothing in games one, two, or three from Taroko. Game four, two goals and an assist, and we've still got time to be played.
I have a very strong feeling we're going to game five. I have a very strong feeling we're going to game five. Just looking at the way these players are conducting themselves, the metas around the map, the in-game synergies, you have to feel that this chess match is going the distance and it's gonna be an incredible final. But for now, Demo looking for a hit. It's just underneath. Corrupted G also gets a nice touch into the corner. And Jacob is there for the stall. Jacob with a nice hit over top. That's two players there to follow up. They're now controlling the left
side. That's open.
Of the field. Here it comes. Mektos looking for a hit, but no, Demo flies over. And that's gonna be a second goal. Is there down just one with a minute 21 to work with.
Demo gets the demo and then takes the pass from Jacob and just puts it in the back of the net. He knew it was wide open. Good heads up play. And they bring 72PC back within one.
Oh, what a story it would be for Jacob to come in and get a game tying, if not game winning goal here. So much time. Taroko trying to make an insurance run possible. Insurance goal, I should say, but Lionblaze over the top. A little bit of an interception and traffic it will be, but Demo comes out. He's able to get a good hit before immediately sent back into the corner of 72. Lionblaze over. Oh, that could have been dangerous if he didn't get a nice little bump. Demo now follows it up, has plenty of boost. Let's see if he can carry it down and try to dunk it lower for a player to come and punch it through, which would have been Jacob. But for now, Corrupted G still hovering on D and has plenty of time to knock that one forward, but a teammate is there.
Demo's gonna be the difference maker in this match. He's going for bumps, going for demos, getting his shots, getting assists. If anyone's gonna do it, it's gonna start through him.
Jacob now in the back, controlling his own corner. He sends it down to the adjacent side. Mekdos with a nice hit. Jacob is there. Here comes Lionblaze, but Taroku gets out in front first. This could be another opportunity, but who's there to follow up? Corrupted G might be the only answer. But right now, he just bumps it up. Jacob with the demo. 9 seconds, 8 seconds, the demo again. We're looking at a game five unless something miraculous happens. I don't think it will. Who could follow up? Oh, this could be a goal. Oh, and it's knocked away at the last second. Taroko with the hit. And we are going to game five. This chess match is taking everything out of me.
Ooh, that one got my adrenaline spiked. And who was it? None other than Demo that put that last shot on target. The hearts are pumping. Oh. The sweat is forming. But either way, we're going to game five.
All that matters is that game five means one person will win. And that means that either one of us will have a correct prediction. So at the end
this
of the day,
true.
It's a win-win. But for now, I am just surprised at the ability for 72 to not only stay in the fight, but you could see they were controlling the pace the entire game until at the end, chaos. They're able to sort of sliver away, and now we go into a game five. I honestly have no clue who's going to win this. I genuinely don't know.
I cannot predict this. I mean, 72 PC, let's just go game by game. Yeah. Just shot totals. Game one, 2 shots. Game three, 9 shots. Game four, 13 shots. Game four has got to be crazy, right? Yeah. 4 shots. I don't know what's going to happen in game five.
Those are some differences that we can't predict for game five because who honestly knows how this is going to go? It could be a one-shot game. It could be a two-shot. It could be a one-goal game. It could be an overtime event. Like, I don't know. These teams are so evenly matched.
Right.
This has been one of the best series we've seen, obviously, today. I think this is going to be one of the best series we could possibly see over and over again as the season progresses. I mean, these teams are head-to-head, evenly matched. It's just a chess match. I love it.
You can't ask for a better way to end the day for the rival series, and it all comes down to this. Game five. Winner goes home with a W. Loser gonna go home feeling bad for themselves.
Off the start, who's gonna strike first? Well, friends, Rocket League fans, we can only wait and see. And I'm sure it's gonna be a good one. Mekdos with a hit, it's off the sidewall. Lionblaze follows it up. There's Jacob trying to get a center. It wasn't gonna happen as Corrupted G says, no. I wanna push this one forward and now carry it by myself. And it could be Taroko with a good punch in, but that down was going to come through, stop the bleeding for now. And Mekdos trying to set up something good.
That was a great pass from Mekdos, but better defense from Lionblaze to get in between the player and the ball, just disrupt things. This ball bombed downfield, going to kiss the ceiling, but Mekdos reads that well.
It was intercepted by Demo. He's been a bit quiet this entire series. Has a couple of demos, which of course just mirror his name, but for now, I mean, we need a couple goals from him. It'd be great to see him show up in game five. That could have been a great shot, but it's immediately pushed away. Lionblaze now staying at midfield, and we are still waiting to see who's going to strike first.
Jacob is just putting all power into his shots. He's just going for the knockout blow here.
Sometimes you need that, especially from a veteran player, to really get you out ahead early. Corrupted underneath. Up is Jacob. He gets the first hit, trying to follow up for a second. Doesn't connect. Taroko now circling. Plenty of boost. Does get demoed. What? From Demo, of all people. And now Mekto sits back, waiting for a cross pattern. Here comes Taroko with a good hit, but no one else is there. And now he's going to go up for a 1v1 before it gets immediately knocked away. And now Mekto's is by himself.
Oh, Jacob almost read that touch from Mekdos. Dangerous. Nets open. Corrupted G looking to play fullback. Gets the screen. Gets Lionblaze out of the way. And Taroko gets the goal.
The patience from Taroko to carry it at the bottom of the field. Last minute. Send it into the upper post so they can't grab it. The corner's completely open. Reading out the defense. Not have to bait him out of any situation. Just great reads all around. Chaos Esports looking good off the start.
And I love the pressure we saw from Corrupted G. He goes flying over, directly overhead the defender. So the defender can't jump. He's forced to stay low, and the shot goes right over his head. Just a beautiful play that developed from Chaos Esports.
Still up in the corner for anyone's game, but 72 will grab it. Taroko, who has been quiet all series until last game, now has a goal to say about it. 2 on the day.
Mekto's looking for some help. Taroko comes over top. That's a beautiful hit, and that's an open goal. Taroko, goal number three. Taroko, 2-0 in this game to put Chaos Esports up by an insurance goal, and they are looking to take game five.
And another feed coming from Mekdos, but 72 PC, a little too aggressive. All three members pushed forward. That's what we saw in the play-ins, and it comes to plague them here in game number five. But still, one half of Rocket League to be played. If one team can score two goals in the first half, the other can absolutely score two in the second.
Those defensive problems are rearing their unfortunate head. A beautiful save from the goal. Beautiful read on the ball as now Corrupted follows it up. They're looking to just put this game out of reach as soon as possible. You can't blame them. Jacob now has to make some magic happen. There's a demo, 3-2 situation. Can they make something positive out of it? No. Lionblaze falls back. Taroko now following in pursuit. Demo has an opportunity, but it's immediately knocked away. Jacob is there. Back to the midfield we go. And Chaos is doing a great job of controlling the pace of this entire game. They are not letting 72 get any position at the field.
Yeah, great spacing. You see Corrupted G pull back there. Brilliant play from a veteran, and Lionblaze completely whiffed on it. Unexpected, but the pass at mid cut off by Mekdos. And Chaos, mid and a half, they just have to hold on.
Taroko now up. Great save from him as he knocks it away into the corner. A minute 22 and counting. Every second that drives by is one less opportunity for 72 PC to come out and find a goal. Now we've reached the 72nd mark, and this could be extremely dangerous if they're not able to find something here.
60 seconds left on the clock.
Taroko gets a nice hit. Who else is there? I believe that's Mekdos over the top, but I think he kind of missed. And now Corrupted G's just waiting, stalling time. And that's exactly what Chaos needs to do. They have a goal to give. Just play back. Play great transitional defense and allow them to try to get aggressive. They've been missing a lot of their hits and just keep knocking the ball away for a clear.
Just let that sand fall through the hourglass. That's all you have to do because there's only a finite amount of it and 30 seconds remain. Good shot off the back wall, and they're not even pressuring it. They're just trying to burn time at this point.
They're trying to keep the ball inside 72's corner. So any possible hit you could have, it would have been great. Taroko with another save. Now a carry towards midfield. It's immediately shot away by Demo. But all of that execution, all of that energy that's being spent has led to nothing. 6 seconds and the series is over. Game five was all of Chaos Esports, and game five belongs to Corrupted G, Taroko, and the entire Chaos Esports crew.